Where there's smoke, there's fire. And where there's fire, at least on NC Wildlife Resources Commission game land, there's usually a prescribed burn. A prescribed burn or an intentional burning of vegetation under strict and specific circumstances helps restore and maintain wildlife habitat. These prescribed burns benefit many outdoor enthusiasts, including hunters, birders, and nature photographers. Controlled burns improve the habitat of native wildlife, such as wild turkey, deer, and some endangered species. A lot of planning goes into deciding where and when we'll perform a prescribed fire. We typically burn on a 2 to 3 year rotation, and depending on the amount of fuel that's on the ground, the wind direction, weather parameters, all determine where we're going to burn, as well as our wildlife habitat objectives. So we've got several objectives for our prescribed burn today. First, we're going to try and reduce the amount of fuel on the forest floor, such as pine needles and dead grasses. Second, we're out here to improve wildlife habitat of this open grassland community that we're managing for. And third, we're trying to reinvigorate the native grassland community. We typically conduct our prescribed burns in two different seasons, dormant season and growing season. During the dormant season, our aim is to reduce fuel. During the growing season, typically we're trying to improve wildlife habitat. We use drip torches, we use hand rakes, and most importantly, we have water trucks on site. Prescribed fire is an extremely cost-effective manner for managing wildlife habitat. It keeps the forest healthy, it benefits the broadest array of wildlife, and it can cost as little as $10 per acre. Residue from the burn will be used as a mineral fertilizer for the plants, and as little as 2 weeks after the burn, you can see they've already started to recover.
In a relatively short amount of time, the native vegetation has returned. The land has rebounded into an area that provides food and cover for native wildlife.